Hi guys, today I'm going to show you how to change the thermal paste on the HP Pavilion AB032TX laptop. But before we start, let me make one thing clear that I am in no way responsible. If anything goes wrong with your laptop, please do it on your own risk. So let's get started. I have already opened up my laptop, so you will have to watch my previous video on how to open up the laptop. I will leave the link somewhere on the screen. You can watch that and then continue watching this video. So, I bought this Deepcool thermal paste, the Z9 variant. I will leave the link in the description below. And I bought this alcohol prep pads. Actually, I couldn't find the solution, and it said that you have to use the ones that have 90%. This is just 70%, but since I was not getting anything, I thought let's give this a try. Let's hope that it works. So on the CPU and GPU, you have to take out around 6 screws, 4 on the CPU and 2 on the GPU. Let's try and take off the heatsink of the CPU and GPU. Looks like it's stuck or glued together. Okay, so it's off. Now I have never opened a laptop before, so I have no idea if this looks like this or it is completely worn out. But since I was still having higher temperatures, I thought I would replace the thermal paste. So let's hope it works. Let me give you a closer look of the CPU and GPU on the motherboard. Zooming in looks kinda crappy, so let me take it off the tripod and show you. As you can see on the GPU, it has spread just a little bit, but on the CPU it looks like it's all over. It has even come down on the motherboard. The thermal paste, I mean. I'm gonna have a hard time cleaning this, I guess. So let's start by cleaning up the heatsink first. As you can see on this pack, it says that it's 70%. It needs to be 90% and higher, but since I was not getting any, I decided to go for this. So I managed to get off all the thermal paste from the heat sink, at least most of it. Now it's time for the CPU and GPU. I'm gonna have a hard time with this. Let's hope for the best. Okay, this wasn't that difficult as I expected. I managed to get off almost all of the old thermal paste. Now let's try and apply the new thermal paste. I will try my best to do it the right way, but with this, I mean, since the chips look so small, I don't know, I might mess it up, but I will still hope for the best. I'll try to just put a line across the chip. Okay, this seems pretty good. Not that bad. Okay. Here I think it's a little extra, and I guess I fudged it up. Let's try the GPU. I think this is okay, but I'll try and take off some of it if I can. Okay, this thing, spoon thing or whatever, it came with the pack. I mean the thermal paste. So let me just try and... Okay, doesn't seem to work, or maybe I'm fudging it up even more. I think I'm confused myself with what method to go. Anyways, let's hope for the best. If it doesn't work well, I might have to open it up and do it again. Let's put the heat sink back in place. While putting it back in place, once it's placed, see that you don't move it around. Okay. Okay. Looks like I need to practice what I preach. Okay guys, so I will put back my PC together. I'll put my PC back together or assemble it again and run a benchmark test on Tomb Raider, Rise of the Tomb Raider. I had run a test before opening up this laptop or before changing the thermal paste, and I will run it again after assembling this laptop just to see if it did any changes or not. Okay, so here I am with the test results. On the left side is the before and the right side is the after. Let's see how it does, or you decide. According to me, it has dropped the temperature a lot. I mean to say, on the CPU by around 10 degrees or more, and the GPU I would say around 10 degrees. Also, please keep in mind that the frame rate, the CPU usage, the CPU temperature, everything is higher during recording, and what you see on screen now, that is during recording. So everything basically runs higher, but most of you guys think that that is the real thing, or that's the correct results, but that's not. So whenever I make a video and you see the frames, the temperature, everything, that's during recording. But I do mention the frame rates, the actual frame rates, in the description, so please make sure to check that out every time. Also, one more thing, I ran this benchmark test after playing the game for around 30 minutes or so. This is the idle temperature of the laptop. I took this screenshot after letting the laptop run for around 10 minutes after boot up, and as you can see, there's a drop of around 9 degrees in CPU and 10 degrees in GPU idle temperature. Hope you guys liked the video. If you did, please hit the like and subscribe button, and if you did not like the video,